Welcome to the modules on leadership. I'm Padmaja. I teach at Center for Health Psychology, University of Hyderabad. I teach 5-year integrated master's program in health psychology and master's program in health psychology, that is IMSC and MSc health psychology at University of Hyderabad. In addition to that, I'm also into guidance of research at PhD level and MSc dissertations as well. I'm going to talk to you today about leadership, several aspects of leadership, starting from today, over 6 days from now on. This whole week, I'll be talking about first module on leadership. I will be talking about leadership and aspects of leadership across 2 weeks in 2 modules separately. Today, I'll be talking about building effective leadership capabilities in engineers, an introduction to it. As I said, this is going to be spread across this whole week, and another week I will be talking about effective leadership traits, qualities and models of leadership. Let me go briefly into this background of leadership. Leadership is the ability of an individual to influence a group toward the achievement of a vision or set of goals. It was considered important that technical skills be imparted to engineers. They were also made to understand the application of these technical skills in the job scenario that they were going to enter into. But then there is a quick change in the global scenario now. There is a lot of need for not only hard skills, but also soft skills. The changing global scenario strongly showcases the requirement of leaders who will also motivate people to deliver the best of their potential on available resources. Present competitive world demands a lot of innovation, and there are differentiators which are heavily based upon the efficacy of leadership of an individual. Here the requirement is an integration of soft skills with the hard skills that they have been trained upon. An engineer today thus looks at not only the tech-driven solutions, but also a collaborative task attainment, which demonstrates and requires appropriate leadership skills. The present module will give a brief introduction, as I have told, to building these leadership capabilities among engineers. We are going to talk about the meaning and definition of leadership, what several researchers and theorists had to talk about leadership, as well as the relevance of these meanings and definitions to the present contexts. As a professional, how an engineer is going to apply these hardened soft skills in his real-time job performance is what we are going to look at. In the later part of the module, we will be talking about the processes involved in the leadership and the functions of a leader, and probably a few styles of leadership. We conclude this week's discussion on leadership with this styles of leadership. In the process of going through these steps that I have been talking about, we will be coming across certain activities, some food for thought for you, the students, and then some exercises probably as a take-home work. In addition to that, probably we will have a discussion over a period of time about several aspects of leadership through the interactive forum as well. I would also suggest certain readings which may be of some help to you for further knowledge about leadership and its processes and styles as well. After opening the interaction forum and after a discussion on the interaction forum, you will have an evaluation process. You will be evaluated both for your participation as well as successful completion of the questions. You will be required to answer about 25 quiz questions, which carry 2 marks each. I would like to mention here that the questions need not necessarily be from my lecture alone, from our discussion alone. They can be from the suggested readings, they can be from the suggested activities, they can be from whatever has been recommended to you to read through. As we progress through this module, you're going to understand the importance of leadership and the role of leadership in the profession chosen by you, how you are going to apply these leadership skills as a part of your profession, and what are the processes involved, and what are the functions required and expected out of a leader. This knowledge building exercise may help you not only in understanding the skills required, but also in the application of the same. One, for the development of the organization that you're going to work for or you're working for. Also importantly, for your self-development. It is felt that the earlier this development process starts, the more the time available for a student or a budding engineer or a young engineer to grow into a leadership role that we have been talking about. Hence, this training at graduation level and during the early part of the career of an engineer. Across the two modules, when we talk about several aspects of leadership, like the meaning, the process, the functions, the styles, and in the next module, when we talk about several aspects of the traits and the qualities required for a leader and the theoretical interpretations of how and what of a leadership and its process, this is going to give you, the student, a comprehensive picture of what leadership means and how it can be exercised as an integration into your job itself. It helps to apply these skills in your life in real-time situations and get the benefit out of whatever you have learned. Context may demand several leadership skills, and let us have a glimpse into several aspects of leadership over these 2 weeks of our discussion on leadership. I and our team wish you all the very best and hope for a very constructive utilization of our presentations and practical application of the same. Thank you.